Missions Pulse. Know God's heart, join his mission.
Over the last decade or so, had the opportunity to be in a lot of different countries on short and longer trips to see what God is doing in those places. And one of the churches that I led, we partnered with a ministry that was helping believers in the Middle East. And in particular, we, as an American church, partnered with a church in that was right outside of Amman, Jordan. And so American church partnered with a Jordanian church that was employing an Egyptian pastor who was reaching Iraqi refugees.
Wow. And that is incredible.
And so, and that's the kind of 7-9 kind of portrait on the earth of moving past your previously established boundaries to say, well, those kind of things can't happen. Well, those kind of things can happen all the time.
Yes.
If you simply decide that the body of Christ is worthy of your investment, which is kind of a ridiculous statement for a, you know, to make, you know, so I say that tongue in cheek with a lot of sarcasm. You know, I need a sarcasm font
something
pops up.
Yeah, I get your sarcasm, but thank you for pointing it out just in case other people missed it.
Yeah, and so it is this opportunity to see that God is working in astounding ways. And, as you and I were talking before we began recording, I had the opportunity to be in Thailand, where you're currently living and ministering. Mm-hmm. To see the work that is being done among refugees from other countries, and the work that is being done within the among believers there in a place where, you know, Christians are most definitely not the majority.
Absolutely.
And so I would say that even in a time like this where there's global pandemic, chaos, where, you know, believers like me in America, we are, you know, there is real danger. There's real physical danger. There's real health danger. But for the vast majority of us, this is an inconvenience. Okay. It's an inconvenience that I can't go to
the store. It'd be fair enough to say that.
Right. And so, but, you know, Angie and I are being careful. We don't want to get sick. But it is an opportunity for, and I've encouraged others, this is a moment to listen to the global church.
I appreciate you pointing that out. I'm sorry to cut you off there. I'm so happy you say that, though, because I think for many Christians around the world who have been living in restricted access countries, this is not a one-off apocalyptic kind of event. It's a one in a series of difficulties that challenge and test their faith regularly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so when we, you know, we sit in our privilege, I mean, because we have economic advantage. I mean, we just do. I was born into it, and I live in it. But it's the opportunity for me to read and to listen and to seek out, and you're going to have to do it, leaders from around the world to hear, well, what do believers in Thailand, Southeast Asia, Middle East, in Africa, where Christianity is oppressed or persecuted, or they are the minority religion, what do believers do there when they live under constant pressure?
Yes.
And I think that those are lessons that we could learn and be prepared for the future of what might happen in our lives personally and what might happen to even culturally.
I like that. And in fact, tomorrow, my wife and I founded a ministry called Within Reach Global many years ago. We have missionaries in China, where we spent many years, 15 years there. We're going to be getting together on Zoom. Please don't Zoom blast us or Zoom bomb us. And meeting with all our local missionaries, as well as our foreign missionaries, taking communion, celebrating the Lord, remembering Jesus together. For many of them, almost all of our local missionaries or indigenous missionaries in China have suffered incredible persecution, from cigarette butt burns on their faces to imprisonment, being followed by plainclothes police. When you go through situations and circumstances like that, I remember one specifically, we call him Zhang Rong online, not his real name, that's a pseudonym. He came to my house with cigarette butt burns all over his face. Had just been in prison and in jail for 3 days. I was very concerned for him, and I said, do we want to take this time, just go home, step away from ministry, kind of, you know, regroup? And he closed his eyes on my couch in Kunming, China, Southwest China, and prayed the most beautiful Acts 29 prayer of saying, thank you, God, that I'm worthy to suffer with you. And the following week, he went back to that same place. These are the kind of challenge, I think, that will help us. And again, I think it brings us back to that Matthew 9:38. The first thing Jesus says when talking about the before he talks about compassion, before he talks about the harvest, he says, lift up your eyes and see. Mm-hmm. Perhaps this is a time when God is allowing us or giving us the opportunity to lift up our eyes beyond our own spheres of influence to see a macro picture of what he's doing in the world.
Yeah. And it's the opportunity that I think for us as believers to pray. I mean, we should be seeking God both. What is it that he wants to and will do in us individually? But from the macro level, could this be a moment where once again, the church globally requests, prays, and persistently asks of the Lord for a revival of the church and a great awakening of the world? I mean, could this be a time where instead of a great awakening in a culture to be localized to one continent or to one region, but that instead that this could be an opportunity for a global great awakening if the church itself would seek the Lord's face for revival of God's own people? Yes. And I certainly I am of a persuasion that the great awakening will come when the great when we submit to the great revival. And so for us and for the church family that we attend, I'm praying that for us. I think that we're a pretty faithful congregation in terms of worship and ministry and being in the Word and caring for one another and for the widow and the orphan in our own city. But I know that there's always a deeper place that a congregation can go with the Lord and with one another.
Yes.
And so as we seek revival in the church, we should pray for a great awakening in the world as well.
Amen.
Missions Pulse. Know God's heart, join his mission. This podcast is powered by Within Reach Global. Subscribe, watch, and listen on YouTube today. Visit missionspulse.com.